Have you ever sat through one of those audio conferences? You know, the long ones which seem to last for days, although it's only hours, where one voice is droning on and everyone else is completely silent and actually doing their emails and you're doing your emails as well. And at the end, somebody says, and we need to do this again next month. And you're hoping the ground will open up and swallow you and you'll die from the boredom of it all. How does that happen? I think what's happened is we haven't understood how to work virtually. As the world has got more complex and got faster, for some colleagues, we get a chance to work with them in the same place in the same time zone. But for many others, they're not in the same time zone, and often they're not even in the same place. And the challenge for you as a manager is suddenly, how on earth do you make this work? How do you manage them? How do you get them to actually aligned and motivated? And the classic mistake people make is they don't understand that managing people virtually is very different from managing them face to face. One of the key things you've got to do first is decide how to create for yourself a cyber personality. What do I mean by that? I'll give you an example. I came across someone the other day and he'd sent across to his manager some sales reports. And there were three bits, if you imagine. The first one said 1 + 1 = 2. The second one said 2 + 4 = 6. And the third one said 3 + 6 = 8. And the manager fired back instantly on his BlackBerry saying, the third one's wrong. Well, what sort of cyber personality is that? I haven't interacted with you for ages, not face to face. I interact with you through cyberspace, and the first thing you do is tell me I'm wrong. So I see you as very negative and unsupportive. So what message do you want to come across? How do you want to be seen? That's one. The second is, because you're not interacting with them face to face and all the time, you don't get cues back. You don't understand whether they've understood you or not. So when you're working as a manager, first thing you've got to get good at is briefing people. When you're telling them, you can't just tell them what to do. You've got to tell them why they need to do it, what the principles are, who else needs to be involved. Give them a chance to work on the process, but really give them some clarity on what performance will look like. And that gives you a cue on how often to update and how often to review and how often to see where they're getting to. The reviews are important as well, because by reviewing, you bring everyone together. So that's what you start to do. You start to think a little bit more about the fact you're not there and you can support them. And then you need to have the right tools. I was joking earlier about audio conferences. Most audio conferences are bad experiences because people don't know how to do them. One of the bits of research we did at Pentacle was to try and build and invent a really good way of doing a good audio conference. And we realized there are really only three elements. The first is whoever's chairing it has to really understand what their role is, and their role is to coordinate and get inputs. And the way you get inputs, which is the second thing, is you make sure you know exactly who's on the call, all 20 of them, you write down their names, and you rotate. So for every single topic, you get an input from every single person. What do you think, Fred? What do you think, Jenna? What do you think, Sue? And then you come back and you summarize it, and then you rotate. And the third thing you do when you're working virtually, if you're coordinating it, is you make sure that all that information is captured as quickly as possible and shared with people. Now, share it with them in the appropriate way. If it's one-to-one, an email's probably good. Emails are great for facts, lousy for anything emotional, great for starting arguments, hard to resolve them. If it's a group of people, make it a wiki, make it something collaborative so that you share the information and they can get to it. So when you're managing virtually, if you have to remember things, remember these. One, make sure that you're clear on how you come across and what your cyber personality is. Secondly, make sure that you've understood how to actually give people tasks and to help and support them. And third, really get on top of your tools. You know, don't imagine that you can do everything just through your emails. You know, just because all you have is a hammer doesn't mean you've got to hit it as if it's a nail. Get very good at using modern collaboration tools.